Welcome to one of the many circle sessions hosted by Wonder Girls. Wonder Girls is a nationwide classrooms movement. We bring relatable female role models into classroom settings through our circle sessions. As you will see, the crux of these sessions is its dialogic nature. We're currently working with 150 plus classrooms across 7 Indian cities. Our aim is for every adolescent in India to have access to relatable female role models. I welcome you once again and hope you enjoy learning from our speakers' life journey and career path.
जो एक ड्रीम था कि कहीं ना कहीं मेरी लाइफ में ट्रैवल हमेशा जुड़ा रहे, वो फाइनली पूरा हुआ। पिछले 2-3 सालों से मैं 9 से 5 की नौकरी नहीं कर रही हूँ और मैं अपने हिसाब से उठती हूँ और बहुत बहुत मजा आ रहा है।
That's really amazing. Like just highlighting the part again and again कि 9-to-5 job नहीं करी, this makes me कितना ज़्यादा hectic होता था और was something that you may not like for a longer time. Since there are a lot of girls now, I would really love if all the girls could just one by one introduce yourself to Didi. Let her know who you are, what you like she shared about her passion. You may also share about yours. And it'll be lovely if you do this while putting your videos on, so that at least she gets a glance of who you are.
Yeah. I want to see your pretty faces, girls. I want to see your pretty faces.
Hey, all right. Let's
go. इधर तो light ही चली गई है.
कोई बात नहीं बच्चे, कोई बात नहीं, जो आपको हल्का सा भी रोशनी मिले बस। मुझे आपकी शक्ल बहुत अच्छे से दिख रही है, आप बिल्कुल चिंता मत करो।
Also at all points you will not forget to follow the class norms. I know Nupur Didi does not know them, but we very well know, right? Our class norms are very simple. We'll raise hands if you want to share, talk, ask questions. And at all other times, we'll be on mute while putting our videos on if the bandwidth allows. Okay? Awesome. So I see Sania raising her hand and is very excited to share. Sania, we'll start off with you only. Go ahead, introduce yourself.
Hi, Didi. I really wanted to ask you this, that how many countries did you travel till now? And the names.
Hi, yes. Sania.
And I'm Sania. Nice to meet you. I just turned 13.
Nice to meet
9th
you.
March.
Thank you so much for your question. You're beautiful, I must say. And don't worry, मुझे आपकी शक्ल बहुत अच्छे से दिख रही है, बहुत light है। How many countries? Not as many countries that I was wanting to.
खाली है। तो मेरे साथ क्यों अपना यदि?
10 countries as of now, and a lot of places in India. I started my first ever trip outside of the country was to Sri Lanka. Phir main gayi Malaysia, Singapore. Phir mera pehla solo trip tha Europe mein, Czech Republic, Austria, Switzerland. Phir mera dream trip, another one, Dubai, Jordan. Aur phir jo ek trip jo mere dil ke bahut kareeb hai, Iran. 2015 में गई, फिर मैं यूएस भी गई, फिर मैं नेपाल भी गई, तो हाँ कुल मिला के आई थिंक 11 or 12 कंट्रीज आई थिंक। और इंडिया में बहुत सारी जगह है, क्योंकि हमारा देश बहुत सुंदर है और बहुत सारी जगह है यहाँ पे देखने के लिए। सानिया आप म्यूट पे हो, मुझे आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है अभी।
No, I was not telling you that. मैं मम्मी बोल रहा था, बड़ी मम्मी को बोल दे, that is why I was telling something.
कोई बात नहीं.
We live in a joint family. Oh, दीदी.
Very good.
Do you want to visit Korea someday?
I would love to visit Korea. I've heard so much about it. I would definitely want to visit it. It's on my list. तो जैसे ही borders खुलेंगे और थोड़ा सा cases better
होंगे. When you visit, please let us know.
हाय सबा, कौन बोल रहा है अभी? सबा?
या दीदी,
क्या बोल रहे हो फिर से? प्लीज क्वेश्चन, मैंने सुना नहीं आपका।
गो टू कोरिया, प्लीज लेट अस नो दैट यू आर गोइंग टू कोरिया।
आई विल मैं सबको बताऊंगी, मैं अपने इंस्टाग्राम पे भी डालती रहूंगी और मैं उसके बारे में लिखूंगी भी, हो सकता है वीडियो भी बनाऊंगी, तो आप जरूर देखना। कोरिया इज ऑलवेज ऑन माई लिस्ट। एक तो मैंने सुना है कि वहां पे कोरिया सुंदर बहुत है, नेचुरल ब्यूटी है और कल्चर बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग है, खाना बहुत अच्छा है, तो डेफिनेटली. इनफैक्ट साउथ कोरिया तक खैर बहुत पॉपुलर है टूरिज्म के लिए. मेरे को नॉर्थ कोरिया जाने का भी बड़ा मन है, थोड़ा सा रिस्ट्रिक्टेड है, बट वो जो क्यूरियोसिटी है टू नो कि वहाँ पे एक्चुअली यू नो हाउ इज इट लाइक, एंड टूरिज्म भी बहुत रिस्ट्रिक्टेड है, टूर गाइड्स के साथ ही जाना पड़ता है, पूरा प्लान ट्रिप होता है, तो मेरा बड़ा मन है जानने का कि असलियत क्या है, मतलब वहाँ जाके ही पता चलेगा. आई थिंक सबसे अच्छी बात होती है ट्रैवल की, पता क्या होती है, तुम्हें पता नहीं होता है आपको कि आप कहाँ जा रहे हो और आपको वहाँ पे क्या मिलेगा, किस तरह के लोग मिलेंगे, कैसा खाना मिलेगा. तो सबसे ज्यादा मजा आता है ना जब आप बिल्कुल क्लीन माइंड से जाते हो, आपके दिमाग में पहले से कोई प्री कंसीव्ड नोशंस नहीं होते हो. जैसे जब मैं ईरान गई थी, मुझे लोग बोलते थे अरे वहां पे क्या बॉम्बिंग हो रही है, वहां पे क्या वॉर है, वहां पे आप कैसे सेफ रहोगे. लेकिन सबसे बढ़िया तरीका होता है कि आप अपने दिमाग को बिल्कुल खाली कर दो, मतलब क्लीन स्लेट. उसके बाद आप जगह पे जाओ, वहां पे खुद जाके देखो, लोगों से मिलो, एक्सपीरियंस करो. और मैंने रियलाइज किया कि यार ये ईरान तो बहुत ही सेफ है, मतलब जैसा बाहर मीडिया में उसके बारे में सुनते हैं तो बहुत ही खूबसूरत देश है, पीपल आर वेरी नाइस, पीपल आर सो वार्म, सो लविंग, एंड इट इज अमेजिंग. मतलब मैं अकेली गई थी, मैं रात रात को ट्रैवल करती थी, मुझे इतना सा भी डर नहीं लगा, बड़ा ही बहुत ही सुंदर देश है, लोग बहुत अच्छे हैं और बहुत ही सेफ है. तो सबसे अच्छी बात होती है ट्रैवल की ना, जो हमारे दिमाग में ये मीडिया जर्नलिस्ट कुछ 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 डालते रहते हैं, एक क्लीन स्लेट बना के जाओ और खुद एक्सपीरियंस करो और खुद डिसाइड करो. और ट्रैवल से क्या होता है ना, बहुत सारी चीजें एकदम दिमाग से प्रेजुडिस सब हट जाता है, आप बहुत ही अलग लाइट में लोगों को देखते हो और बहुत ही रिस्पॉन्सिबल और बहुत ही स्मार्ट भी हो जाते हो और लोगों को समझते हो जब आप ट्रैवल करते हो. तो सानिया, आई विल टेक यू अलोंग इफ आई गो टू कोरिया. जब भी मेरा प्लान बनेगा मैं आपको पहले ही बता दूंगी, हम अपना ट्रिप पहले से ही प्लान कर लेंगे.
इसको वहां पे छोड़कर भी आ जाना, she'll be very happy. है ना सानिया, you will love it, right?
Yes, I love it. पूरी जिंदगी उधर निकाल दूंगी.
I will take you along.
There are some students in class who also speak Korean and can write in Korean. Wow. Just yeah, adding the
that point. Is amazing. फिर तो I will need your help. तो आपको मेरी हेल्प चाहिए, मुझे आपकी हेल्प चाहिए होगी. मैं आपसे कुछ कुछ वर्ड सीख के जाऊंगी. हाँ, बेसिक बेसिक, क्योंकि मुझे नहीं आती कोरियन.
These girls are very curious about Korean music.
Korean. Done, सानिया एंड सबा, मैं आपसे सीख के जाऊंगी और फिर दोनों को साथ में लेके जाऊंगी, तो मेरे लिए तो ट्रांसलेटर्स हो जाएंगे वहां पे, मेरे लिए तो कोरिया ट्रिप हो जाएगा.
Since Tanya started off with her introduction and a beautiful question which gave light to another interesting discussion, I would really want more girls to raise hands and start introducing themselves to Didi and continue this wonderful discussion that we've really started off. Tanya, you may rest for a while. If you have any more questions, we'll take it up after a few questions from the other girls.
I think there is one question that is coming up from Sheikh Palaknaz.
Yes, Palaknaz.
Palaknaz. वो मुझसे पूछ रही है कि आप हाउ डू यू अर्न बाय ट्रैवलिंग. आई विश मुझे, मैं ट्रैवल करती हूँ, मुझे अपने आप बहुत सारा पैसा मिल जाता. बट देखो बहुत सारे तरीके होते हैं. एक होता है कि आपका जो कोर एरिया ऑफ इंटरेस्ट है, योर प्रोफेशन इज एज अ ट्रैवल ब्लॉगर. तो आप जब ब्लॉग करते हो, आप ट्रैवल करते हो, आप किसी दूसरी जगह को लोगों को दिखा रहे हो, तो क्या होता है ना, आपकी फॉलोइंग बढ़ रही है, आपके साथ बहुत सारे लोग जुड़ते हैं, आपके बहुत सारे फॉलोअर्स हैं, और फिर आपको ब्रांड्स भी चांस देते हैं. टूरिज्म बोर्ड्स, जैसे कोरिया टूरिज्म मेरे पास आके बोलेगा अरे आपके इतने फॉलोअर्स हैं, हमको इंडिया से और टूरिस्ट चाहिए, तो आप हमारे लिए, हमारे साथ एक कोलैबोरेशन करो, वी विल, आपको कितने सारे लोग फॉलो करते हैं, आप उनको दिखाओ कि कोरिया कितना सुंदर है. तो एक वो तरीका होता है कि ब्रांड्स आपको कोलैबोरेट करके आपको पैसा देते हैं कि देखो आप हमारे देश के बारे में या हमारे जो भी रीजन के बारे में और लोगों को दिखाओ. मेरा सिर्फ ट्रैवल ब्लॉगिंग तो है ही, बट मेरी एक क्रिएटिव एजेंसी भी है. तो मैं ब्रांड्स के लिए बहुत ही सुंदर वीडियोज और फोटोग्राफ्स खींचती हूँ, हमारी एजेंसी, तो उससे भी पैसा मिलता है. प्लस मैं अपने इंडिविजुअल कंटेंट असाइनमेंट्स भी लेती हूँ. आई राइट फॉर पीपल, राइट आर्टिकल्स, इट कुड बी अबाउट ट्रैवल, इट कुड बी अबाउट एनीथिंग, अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. सो डिफरेंट चीजों से आपको सोर्स ऑफ इनकम डिफरेंट डिफरेंट हो सकता है. अगर आप में से कोई है जो बिल्कुल ट्रैवल ब्लॉगर बनना चाहते हो, फिर आपका फोकस उस पर रखिए. आप अपने एक इंस्टाग्राम पे बनाइए एंड मेक श्योर कि जब आप धीरे धीरे अपना ये काम कर रहे हो, दो तीन डिफरेंट प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे अपना प्रेजेंस रखो यूट्यूब पे, क्योंकि सिर्फ एक चीज पे इफ यू बी डिपेंडेंट ऑन जस्ट इंस्टाग्राम, कल को इंस्टाग्राम की पॉपुलरिटी कम होगी तो फिर आप क्या करोगे? यू नो, मेक श्योर दैट यू हैव अ यूट्यूब चैनल, राइट अ ब्लॉग. तो धीरे धीरे जब आपके साथ लोग जुड़ते जाते हैं हु लाइक यू, हु लिसन टू यू, आपको फिर ब्रांड्स अप्रोच करते हैं, यू गेट मनी टू कोलैबोरेट विद ब्रांड्स, उनके प्रोडक्ट्स, उनके डेस्टिनेशंस आपके साथ अगर आप उनके बारे में प्रमोट करते हो देन पीपल पे यू फॉर इट. एक और तरीका होता है, आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव दिस मिसकंसेप्शन कि अरे हम तो रेगुलर नौकरी करते हैं, हम ट्रैवल नहीं कर सकते. क्या? बिल्कुल कर सकते हो. आई थिंक देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ वेज जहाँ पे आप अपनी छुट्टियां बचा के स्मार्टली कम पैसों में बहुत सारी जगह पर ट्रैवल कर सकते हो, रेगुलर काम करके भी. बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जो ट्रैवल ब्लॉगर्स नहीं है क्योंकि शायद उनका स्किल सेट नहीं है या फिर उनको बनना नहीं है, बट उनका स्किल सेट कुछ और है, यू नो. तो वो उस स्किल सेट के साथ पैसा कमा के साथ में उसी पैसे से बहुत सारा ट्रैवल करते हैं, बट यू हैव टू बी स्मार्ट अबाउट इट. तो बहुत तरीके हैं, जरूरी नहीं है कि जो आप देखते हो कि सब यूट्यूबर या ब्लॉगर बन जाए, सब एडिटर बन जाए, जरूरी नहीं है कि आप सिर्फ वही करके ट्रैवल कर सकते हो. आप बहुत सारी और चीजें कर सकते हो जिसके साथ, जैसे मैं आपको एक बताती हूँ, मैं ईरान में एक लड़की से मिली थी, चाइना की थी, लिंगर लुओ. मैं उसे जिंदगी भर नहीं भूल सकती, लिंगर लुओ. मैंने कहा यार ये कमाल की लड़की है, 9-10 महीने से घूम रही है, ये पैसे कैसे कमाती है? तो लिंगर लुओ ने बाल काटना सीख लिया था. तो लिंगर लुओ जहां भी जाती थी वहां पे लोगों के बाल काटती थी और उससे पैसा कमाती थी और फिर अगली डेस्टिनेशन में ट्रैवल करती. तो कई बार ऐसा होता है ना, आपका स्किल सेट कुछ और होता है जो ट्रैवल से रिलेटेड नहीं होता, या फिर ऐसा नहीं है कि आप ट्रैवल ब्लॉगर हो या फिर आपका स्किल सेट कुछ और है, बट वो स्किल सेट आप अलग अलग जगहों पे यूज कर सकते हो पैसा कमाने के लिए और ट्रैवल करने से. तो मैं भी ऐसा ही ट्राई करती हूँ. मेरा स्किल सेट है, मुझे लिखना बड़ा पसंद है, बहुत पसंद है. आई लाइक टू राइट, आई लव टू राइट. तो आई अर्न सम मनी फ्रॉम राइटिंग एंड सम फ्रॉम ब्रांड कोलैबोरेशंस एंड आई पुट दैट मनी टुगेदर एंड देन आई ट्रैवल मोर.
That's lovely. Just wondering that doing all of this would really take a lot of time, mental energy. So how do we balance those periods wherein we're enjoying what we're doing, but it's not getting converted into something tangible?
Well, I think that's a very good question, because a lot of times when you think of travel, humko lagta hai it's more leisure. It's a leisure activity. As soon as it becomes something that is work, it is very difficult to maintain that balance. But what I try to do when I'm traveling is I take some time off, like I detach from the digital world, from everything, from creating videos, from clicking pictures, and I detach and I experience the place just for myself. So I make sure that I take out time for that, and then I take out time for my work as well. I think it is very important to not see a destination as just कि आप पिक्चर फोटो खींचने जा रहे हो या वीडियो बनाने जा रहे हो. आई थिंक इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप वहां पे जगह के बारे में समझो, लोकल लोगों से बात करके पूछो, उनका कल्चर समझो. कोई ना कोई कहानी होती है, देयर इज ऑलवेज अ स्टोरी बिहाइंड अ डेस्टिनेशन और अ प्लेस और अ ट्रेडिशन. यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट, एंड फॉर दैट यू नीड टू टेक आउट सम मोर टाइम. फॉर मी आई काइंड ऑफ ट्राई टू बैलेंस दैट आउट. देयर आर लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स आई टेक ट्रिप्स जो विच हैव नथिंग टू डू विद वर्क. So I just go somewhere without like wanting to click pictures or take videos, because that is just for me, just to take that break. But I think I'm privileged and I am grateful that I have a job that allows me to travel, because a lot of people want to do that, but they don't. So I'm grateful. I don't take it for granted. That is one thing. You travel with partners. My favorite thing is to travel alone. This is from Ayman. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing it wrong.
It's Ayman.
Ayman. My favorite thing is to travel solo. बड़ा ही मजा आता है जब कोई नहीं बोलता यहाँ चले वहाँ चले ये करे. मैं खुद से डिसाइड करती हूँ यहाँ चलना है ये करना है. There are times जब मैं सिटी स्क्वायर में ना चार चार पांच पांच घंटे बैठ जाती हूँ अपनी नोटबुक के साथ, just to scribble something and talk to people and experience the place. But I also travel with groups and friends. I think sabka alag alag different experience hota hai, so I love to do that. How did you learn all the languages in different countries? Ganchi, Sadaf. Main kya karti hu, jab bhi main kahin jaane wali hoti hu na, main unke basic cheeze seekh leti hu. Matlab hello, how are you, sorry, please, excuse me, thank you. To ye sab main pehle hi seekh leti hu, kyunki locals ko bada acha lagta hai ki you have taken some effort to learn the language. I think that's very important. like they're welcoming you to their homes, to their country. I think you can like take out some time and learn their language. It's nice because it gives you, there are a lot of countries jahan pe language is a can be a barrier because you know you don't know. But ek aur cheez hai na, I think people are so warm in a lot of places. Kai baar to sign language jo matlab aise random wala, you don't know what you're saying, you don't know, wo bhi chal jata hai. So it is fun, it is interesting. If you're a traveler, you would also like taking photos. Falaknaz, I do. I'm not a great photographer, but I like to capture everything. And I love capturing architecture. Kahin pe bhi kuch bahut different architecture dikhta hai na, I click it and then I read about it. So mujhe wo bahut acha lagta hai. Do you know Korean? There are so many Korean fans and Korean dramas. Nahi yaar, maine koi nahi dekha. Please mujhe suggest karo Netflix pe koi acha.
Okay, didi, I'll suggest you.
I will watch.
Any non-Korean questions, girls, that you have and want to ask about your travel?
No, they aren't.
Didi, when you travel, so you got some difficulties or you may not?
There are always challenges when you travel. I think when I go for a travel, in my head, I know that I might face problems. There are challenges sometimes, you know, you're stuck somewhere. Or there was this time that I was in New York and I was couch surfing. Couch surfing is a concept where you stay with hosts for free. They offer you their homes for free. And it is a great way to budget travel. It is, you have to make sure that, you know all the risks and everything. But there was this one time that due to some unforeseen circumstances, I didn't have a place to stay for the night in New York. I was like, oh God, I'm going to be on the road for the night. But I managed to find a stay last time. I think challenges hamesha aate hain in terms of languages or stay or, you know, you're stuck somewhere. The best thing is to not panic. Think smart. Keep calm, be confident. Aur kai baar aisa hota hai, log jaise hamesha backup thoda thoda chalke rehna padta hai. For instance, if I'm going somewhere to couch surf, I'm staying with a host, but in the back of my head, I know there's a possibility that I might not like it. So maine already dekh liya hota hai ki pass mein kaun sa hotel hai, kaun sa hostel hai. So, you know, I never let my guard down. Kahin pe bhi aap jao, you never let your guard down. What I mean by that is you're always aware. You know what is happening around you. So, koi bhi challenges, koi bhi difficulties aati hai na, it is very easy then to overcome it. And you be calm and confident. The one thing that you girls have to remember if you're traveling solo is, even if there is a challenge and you have a problem, you know it. Make sure that the others around you don't know it. Because, you know, the kind of world that we live in, a lot of times you become very vulnerable. So, what travel also does to you is, you learn how to trust people. So trust other people, trust your gut, your instinct, but always be very aware. How do you decide where to travel next? There are so many places in my list. Whenever I, depending on what time of the year it is or where the situation is, you know, or it's fine for me to travel. I'm not a pre-planner. I don't plan like a lot in advance. I just have places on my list, jo jab mujhe mauka milta hai, I check it off. So I'm not much of a pre-planner. When you travel, do you wear the traditional clothes? That's from Mahira Sheikh. Mahira, kabhi kabhi. You know, sometimes it's nice to respect, I think it's always good to respect other people's traditions. A lot of countries don't expect you to wear their traditional clothes, but kuch countries mein hoti hai, jaise, जब मैं ईरान गई थी तो दे आर वेरी पर्टिकुलर कि आप अपने बाल ढको, आप स्कार्फ पहनो, आप कुछ ऐसा लंबा पहनो जो आपका बैक साइड कवर हो जाए. तो ऑफकोर्स आप जहां पे भी जाते हो, आपको कोई वेलकम कर रहा है इन देयर कंट्री, इन देयर होम्स, यू हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट देयर ट्रेडिशन. सो इफ देयर इज अ कंट्री दैट आई गो टू जहां पे कुछ रिस्ट्रिक्शंस या कुछ ट्रेडिशंस हैं जो दे एक्सपेक्ट करते हैं टूरिस्ट को भी फॉलो करना, आई मेक श्योर दैट आई डू दैट बिकॉज यू नो It's that's how it should be. You should respect other people. Jaise hamare yahan pe koi aata hai, hum hamare ghar ko hi aata hai, hum expect karte hain, you know, they respect how we live. I think the same goes with travel. You have to respect other people's cultures and traditions. It's actually nice because aapko experience karne ko milta hai ki wo locally kaise rehte hain, to bada maza aata hai actually. So yes, I have done that, and that's amazing.
Before we take questions from the chat box, Sabha has been raising her hand. She needed to ask something. Yes, Sabha, go ahead.
Like Didi, you said you go in Iran, you travel in Iran. So where do you particularly stayed?
For Iran, I actually stayed with locals. So there is an online platform called Couchsurfing. It is a platform for travelers who want to stay with local hosts in different countries. So I looked up hosts beforehand in different cities that I was planning to stay in from Couchsurfing, and I stayed with locals. I stayed with their home, in their homes with their families. So I did not stay at a hostel or a hotel in Iran. I wanted to experience living.
No, I was asking the place name.
Oh, the place name? I was in Tehran, which is the capital of Iran. Then I went towards Tabriz, which is near their western border. Then I went to Isfahan, Yazd, Shiraz, and back to Tehran. And what I used to do is, when I was in all of these cities, I would take out a couple of days to experience around the city. So I would keep the city as my base and then travel around these cities. So I was in Iran for good 22 days. Which was still less. मुझे तब भी लग रहा था बहुत कम दिन है, because such a beautiful country. But yeah, I managed to do that.
Okay, thank you.
No worries.
I had a follow-up question.
Who else?
I think Sanya had been raising her hand.
Yes, Sanya, tell me.
So Didi, my question is that what inspired you a lot to do traveling? Like Didi said in the comment that you inspired from couch surfing, but how did you get along with it? Like, there must be a day where you went there and everything would have happened and this thing came in your mind.
I think as a kid, what inspired me to travel was my father, because I was born in Kashmir. And my family moved out of the valley when I was very little. We came to Delhi, and I used to see my dad's pictures, because he used to trek a lot in the mountains. And I used to see his pictures of trekking with his friends across Kashmir. And I was so inspired and I was so awestruck that this is beautiful. You know, how did you do it? Where did you live? How did you live in tents? Where did you go to use the washroom? You know, I was a little kid, and all these things, it made me very curious. And I think I've got the travel bug from my father. He's also been very curious, and he's been an explorer, and he loved mountains. I love mountains. I love to trek. And that's how I got it. That's how I started to explore. So whenever I would get a chance to go for a small trip, say a college trip, or when I started working, a work trip, I would extend it by a few days and, you know, kind of try to explore the place around. I think that's how it started, and I realized I love traveling so much. I mean, it's just addictive, you know. Once you start doing it and you love it, you can't stop, because it is all about knowing other places. It's not just about seeing those places, it's about meeting those people, living their life, experiencing it. It's about, for a moment, you're in a different reality. You are like far away from your day-to-day work or your school or your studies or your parents or your friends. You're in a stranger land, and you know, everything is new and it's so beautiful. And I think that's what inspires people to keep traveling again. And it teaches you so much. You know, whenever you go for your first solo trip, you are going to remember me. You're going to say like, yes, this is amazing. I have the control, but at the same time, I have to be cautious. You know, I understand the chart. Can I trust this person? Can I trust this person? No, I can't trust this. You know, it teaches you so many things. And then you think, no, I thought this is how it's supposed to be in this place, but it's not. It's so different. Like, you know, I thought people won't be that friendly, but people are so friendly, you know. It teaches you so many things. It teaches you kindness and empathy. And when you go for your first solo trip, Sanya, remember me always.
My first solo trip will not be a solo trip. It will be with you.
Okay, great. Great. Well, I'll be honored to travel with you. So
drop me at Seoul and go away. I'll take my oppa with me.
Okay, done.
Okay. Before I move ahead to Faiza and Shifa, who've been raising their hands, I had a follow-up question from your share. So we're talking a lot about what travel is, how is travel going in places, how lovely it can be both personally and professionally. But just imagining that tomorrow one of us suddenly realizes that, oh yes, this is some new thing that we want to try, or we suddenly realize that, okay, we want to be travelers, what are some basic skills, mindsets, or certain ways that we definitely need to be prepared if at all we're just thinking to travel frequently, may not necessarily be, you know, professionally. Like tomorrow, if the kids want to just start traveling on their own, what are certain prerequisites that they should definitely be aware of and have it in them?
I think whenever you decide to travel, one, as I mentioned before, never go to a place with a preconceived notion about a place. Make sure that you don't have things in your head that's going to be like this, it's going to, don't do that. Be with a clean slate of mind. Second, what I do, and I would recommend everybody to do, try to read as much about the place as possible. There are a lot of things that you learn about places when you go there, but you can do a lot of your homework so that you are well prepared. Some people like me don't like a lot of planning, but there are people who like to plan. There should be some basic planning in place. Like these are the kind of places that you would want to visit. Like this is the time frame that you have. And these are the kind of places. And if you are a vegetarian, you know, are there food options there? Do you want to carry something with you that you can cook? There are a lot of places where you can't find a lot of options that you like to eat. So do that in terms of safety. Where are you staying? Are you staying in a place which is like tourist friendly? But at the same time, if you want to stay at a place which is like a little away from the tourist center, what are the things you keep in mind? You keep your, you know, you keep things with you for safety. You keep like a pepper spray, or you know, like, unfortunately, we have to think about these things when we're traveling as girls in this country or abroad. Staying close to the city center. A lot of times I prefer to stay close to a tourist site, you know. So these are the semantics, but in general, I think keep an open mind, be confident. Even you know, like when you're traveling, you keep in your mind that you will face challenges. You might face challenges. It might not always be a smooth ride. Be very confident. Have some emergency, you know, contacts. If you're going somewhere where you know people, if at all, then make sure that you know their contacts. If not, make sure that you tell somebody in your family or your friends that this is your plan and this is how you're planning to go. So it's always good to keep a lot of backups and a lot of, you know, you have to create your safety net when you're traveling. So do that. But I think just follow your gut. I think that's my number one learning for me. Follow your instinct, follow your gut. If you think that something is not right for you, don't do it. You, a lot of people will force you, urge you to do something that you might not want to do. Don't do it. You know, travel is a very personal experience. It should not be dictated by social media or Instagram or Facebook or, you know, online. It is very personal. If you don't feel like doing something just because somebody else is putting pictures of it, don't do it. You know, it's very personal. You do what you want to do, what you are comfortable doing. And I think once you open your mind and follow your gut, open your mind, follow your gut, and I think you'll have a great travel experience. And I tell a lot of people, even when, like, and if you're looking at something professionally, like later on travel, I tell people, you follow your heart, but make sure that you apply your mind as well. You know, if you want to just like, if I had just thought I'll leave everything and just start traveling, where will I get the money to do that? So I have to apply, it is my heart, it is what my heart wants, but I have to apply my mind as well. I have to know, okay, I have to have these many months of savings. I have to kind of make sure that I get additional jobs side by side to get that money coming, because I have to sustain. I've never been dependent on other people financially in the last 10 years. Like, it is a mix of your heart and your mind. So that is the most important thing that you have to do when you're deciding on traveling.
I think it beautifully covers, like, for a lot of things generally in life also, that you need to just balance your heart and mind wherever you go, whatever you do. And with that, let's move ahead to Shifa. She's been raising her hands, and then Salva. Yes, Shifa, go ahead.
So Didi, when you travel, like you tell that I travel and I ask to everyone that about the country and the language. So when you ask them, so they do not
shout at you, or maybe when we tell to someone that what is this and what is this, so they shouted. Generally they shouted, no no no, go from your, I don't want to say you like that. So does it happen with you?
Yes, it does happen. I think that is the beauty of human beings, right? There are so many, like, you know, you never know. That's the beauty of emotions. What I do is if I ask somebody, hey, excuse me, can you tell me where this, and this guy says, you know, like, I don't know. I think, okay, maybe this guy is having a really hard time, you know, maybe there's something bothering him at work or at home. So maybe he's not in a good mood. It's okay. I think don't take anything personally against anybody, because you don't know what they're going through in their lives. But fortunately, I have always met, like 90% of the time, Shifa, I've met very friendly people wherever I go. A lot of places where I go, and a lot of places people would tell me that, you know, the people there are not very friendly. Like some people told me, you know, go to Austria, they're not very friendly, but I found the most friendliest people. I think when you are a happy, respectful person, people kind of behave in the same way. That's what I believe. And I think you throw those positive vibes in the universe, they're always going to come back to you. So when I'm like very nice, and I know that I'm not disturbing the person, and you know, the person is not like seeming very busy with something, and I respectfully approach them, and you know, a please and a thank you go a long way, wherever, even in our normal lives, you know. So when you ask them normally, they do take time to respond. And if they don't take it personally, just move on to somebody else who would like to be, you know, helpful to you. So don't worry. You never know what people are going on in their lives, right? So they might just be having a really bad day. You know, there are times that we have a very bad day and we say like, mujhe nahi pata, abhi nahi, baad mein, you know, you never know. So it's always, again, open mind. Theek hai, koi baat nahi. You'll always find somebody who's your friend and who's going to find time to answer you. So yeah.
Shifa wants to add on. Just before that, I'd like to add a bit of my experience. So
yes.
I was traveling. I'm not very avid when I travel. I have a lot of health and climate constraints somehow.
Okay.
It just doesn't suit me well. So although I love traveling, I'm not able to do it very often. But this theology actually applies there, that there have been instances where very random people in states like Rajasthan and Mumbai, where people just are not having time to even look at you,
yeah,
be very kind enough to give you a lot of help, stay, and etc. And then there are times where you might try a lot and yet not find somebody very hospitable. So it actually depends on a lot of factors. But like Didi said, that at the end, you need to be clear, open-minded, and accepting ki whatever the situation is, you have come with a purpose. And you need to just go ahead with that with a very positive state. Because you imagine that you're already alone and then you get disheartened because of all these experiences. It's going to be a big mess then in a very unknown city or any other place that you go to. So, yeah.
Couple of questions. I think Falakna said, you love mountains. I love mountains too. Sadaf, I do visit the famous places. I do a mix of the famous places and the ones that are not very famous. I do that. And monuments, who asked me about monuments? Sadaf, I love architecture, I love history, so I do visit the monuments wherever I go. I love them. I think that there are so many stories to tell from times that, you know, you just always in awe of. So I love monuments. I always visit monuments wherever I go. Yes.
Shifa, you had a follow-up question, but before Shifa, you ask your follow-up, can I request Faiza to ask a question, as she's been raising her hand for a really long time?
Yes, Faiza, tell me.
Go ahead. It'll be easy to keep your video on as well, like Shifa.
So, Didi, how did you come up with traveling? Like, how do you know that I'll be traveling when I grow up, then I'll travel?
I didn't know that for the longest while. For me, traveling initially was just like, you know, taking a vacation or a trip. But I think I love to read, Faiza. I love to read. And apart from when I said about my father being an inspiration, I read about so many magical places. I used to watch a lot of documentaries. I used to read a lot of books. And in my head, I used to think about, oh, I wonder how these places will be, you know. I think that's what nudged me to know more about these places. I remember, I'll give you an example for you to understand me better. When I was little, I think I was 11 or like maybe like around your age, I saw a documentary on Persepolis, which is the lost empire of Darius the Great. And I was like, oh, wow, I want to visit the ruins of this, you know, magical city of Persepolis someday. And then I realized that it is in present day Iran. And then I realized that I am a Kashmiri and my roots are from Iran. And I'm like, you know, that's amazing. Like, I want to go and see this place where my ancestors have come from. So I think these small little things, you know, you read about a place, you want to know. There was this beautiful cemetery that I saw. I used to see it on Google. It was a beautiful cemetery which had a lake, overlooking a lake and then the mountains. In my head, I already had a picture of it and I'm like, oh, I have to go there someday. And I did. I went to Austria. I found in this small village called Hallstatt, I found that very cemetery and I choked. Like, I'm not kidding. I cried, guys. I cried there because I'd seen it on Google so many times. And I'm like, I have worked so hard. I have saved every single penny. And I finally am here. You know, I think travel gives you that gratification and it is beautiful. And it's something that you can only experience when you do it. So whenever you guys do it, you're going to think of these moments. You're going to think right now, like, oh my God, did she cry? Why did she cry? But maybe when it's like so passionate to you, you will remember me someday if it happens to you.
I could actually resonate so much that I want to again add up one of my experiences.
Yeah, yes, please.
So I remember when Nupur Didi was talking about the fact that you need to just imagine, like, you know, in your head, that should be visually clear whenever you maybe read and get excited or fascinated, or you just come across something that you probably like. So I remember as a child, like, I think 8th standard will soon be knowing about it. There was a chapter in my biology textbook which talked about a flower called as Strobilanthus kunjana. That's its scientific name, and it's actually called as Neela Kuranji in Hindi. So if you would know about that flower, वो 12 years में एक बार flower करता है, मतलब 12 years उसको लगते हैं reproduce करने में. We've all studied about it, right? And that flower is so beautiful, like it's purple colored and pink colored, that it really covers the whole valleys of mountains with a lot of flowers. So when you actually see it flowering in mass, you would really see purple pink colored mountains. And बहुत कम जगहों पे ये flower होता है, in India only, but mostly in the southern part of India. So I remember when I was a kid and in 8th standard, I had decided ki I had calculated mentally ki 12 years baad abhi next ka flower karne wala hai, and it was supposed to be flowering in 2018 according to that calculation. So since then it was in my head, like it was so stuck clearly that immediately when 2018 came up, I told my mama, let's think, let's plan something. We actually were planning, we planned also. And unfortunately, उसी साल केरला में बहुत massive floods हुए थे. Around the same time जब ये flower दिखने वाला था. But I was so, मतलब in my head, in my heart, I so wanted to just visit this place that somehow after everything got settled and the state was recovering, we replanned that trip and we did go to that place जहाँ वो flower होते हैं. But फिर भी बहुत कम बचे थे, उनका फ्लावरिंग पीरियड खत्म हो चुका था, डिस्ट्रॉय कितना हुआ था सब कुछ, तो काफी कुछ ही बचा हुआ था. एक वो होता ना सोल सैटिस्फैक्शन नहीं मिल रहा था, क्योंकि मुझे चाहिए थी पर्पल कलर्ड वैली जो नहीं दिख रही थी. बट ऐसा होता है दैट व्हेन यू वांट समथिंग यू डेफिनेटली डू समथिंग फॉर इट. सो आई रिमेम्बर जस्ट द नाइट बिफोर वी हैड टू ट्रैवल बैक, आई वाज जस्ट गूगलिंग रैंडमली एंड एक ऐसे ही केबिन के बारे में मुझे पता चला जहाँ पे ये गार्डन किया जा रहा था फ्लावर. And it turned out to be a police station in Munnar.
Wow.
So I remember 7:30 baj chuke the, ekdam andhera ho jata hai, hilly areas hote hai, wo plus barish ka mausam tha, bahut heavy rain hone lag gaya tha, to pure raste mein bahut foggy tha. It was so matlab dark that the driver, who is a very experienced person, was actually scared ki hum kahin gir na jaye khaye mein. But I was so sure ki nahi jana hai, band hone ka time ho raha hai, let's go karke we reached. And then I just entered and I see that purple valley.
Wow.
In the form of a garden. But that was a very high moment in my life. And I could really resonate when Nupur Didi was saying that, you know, when you really, really want to do something, maybe especially while traveling, these experiences.
No, absolutely. I think for everybody, positive reinforcements are very important. So whenever you really want something, you want to do something, you keep telling yourself, you be positive, you tell yourself that it will happen. I will do this. I will go there. You know, I will, when you positively reinforce all of these things, they do happen. You know, the universe does listen. So all of you girls, remember it, like positive reinforcements are very, very important. Everything, and it's not just for travel, everything. Like today is going to be a good day. Today I'm going to be productive. Today I'm going to learn something new. Every single day, start your day with positive reinforcements and it'll always help. A couple of other questions I think I saw have the Falaknas. Have you visited Antarctica? It's on my, it's on the top five in my list. Someday, someday I will. we'll take some writing tips. Most welcome, Jay. Most welcome. Everybody can take writing tips from me. I'm living in Delhi, Shifa. I am based in Delhi. My favorite place so far, so many. But I think Iran holds a very, I think I keep talking about it. You would have guessed by now. It holds a very, very special place in my heart because it just broke a lot of misconceptions, even in my mind. Even if I've read so much about it and I went with a pretty clear slate, it still was a beautiful trip. On which trip you felt you didn't want to come here again, Faiza? I think I feel that on all trips. I never want to come back. But then I know that I have to come back. But in my head, I know if I come back, that means I'm going to plan another trip. So yeah, Shifa wants to ask. Shifa, you follow up question, please. Yes.
Go ahead, Shifa. So sorry to take your time. Yeah.
It's okay. So my question is that means you just imagine that I want to go to travel to this place and from this place, I will go to this place. So decide to go to somewhere or to go to another place to travel and to know about the people and the language. So what will difficulty come at you and how did you manage your parents to say yes to go?
That's a very nice question. That's a very important question because I struggled for so many years to do that. I think my parents, very early on, when I started to travel, I was usually doing it for work and I was just extending it. For my parents, it was a work trip, which I had extended, so they wouldn't say much. But when I actually wanted to travel by myself, it took me some time. So my parents, like a lot of Indian parents, were pretty conservative about, you know, kaise karoge. I think hum ye realize nahi karte, but it mostly stems from your safety. Like, will she be safe? Will she be okay? I think the homework that I did, I made them realize over a period of time that this is not just a vacation for me. You know, it is an experience. This is that is something that I will derive out of. That is something that will help me. That is, it's, you know, people feel ki chutti to hai, vacation. Now, usse kya hai? Matlab chill hi to karne ja rahe ho. But no, if you make your parents realize that it's actually like, you know, a learning for you. It teaches you so many. It's an experience that will make you grow as a person. I think once they realized that it was not just a trip or a vacation for me and that this was my passion and I felt so passionately about learning and knowing about a place, experiencing it, it takes time. I know, I have been there. It takes time, but if you keep making your parents understand over a period of 1-2, it took me a lot of years. I'm not saying it like it suddenly happened. It took me like good 3-4 years for them to understand ki yaar nahi, you know, this is something else. She really, really enjoys it and this is so much more to her. I think they finally let go. I think it is a process of making your parents understand. At the same time, you have to respect what they want and expect from you as well. For instance, when I went for my first solo trip, my father's major concern was my safety. And I understood that because that's what all of our parents do have. So I made sure that I explained it to him, every place I'll be going to, these are the hostels that I'll be staying in. This is what the hostel culture is all about. This is the public transport in that place and it is going to be safe. Don't worry. I always have, you know, these things kept in mind. I don't keep all of my cash in one place. Don't worry, I split it. I always have my passport and all of my identity and everything with me, safe. I don't speak with a lot of strangers, but when I do, I make sure that I trust my instinct and I know that I'm in a public place and not in like a far off, you know, small street where there's no light. You know, I made them understand that I am an adult. I understand. I like my care about my safety more than anybody else. So I will manage. But at the same time, if I took a step, you know, if they took a step forward, I also took a step towards them. That okay, I'm going to make sure that you know where I'm at, what I'm doing, you know, like give you that one call a day, like, hey, it was a great day. I think parents, that's all they want. You know, they just want you to be safe and sound. And as much as we want to travel as early as possible, there are times that you can't. And I think give your parents time. Eventually, even when you grow up, there are a lot of things that you will learn. When you feel ready to go out in the world and travel by yourself, I think you give it some time, parents will eventually understand. Once they understand how important it is for you, they do understand. And you have to make sure that you tell them that you're going to be able to take care of yourself. That's all they want. So, yeah, if that answers your question.
You have another question?
Okay, so I want to say a question also, and I want to say something else also. So my question is that when you travel to the places, do you write all the things and all the means? Just as you have a step, buddy, आपने सारी चीजें देखी सब की. Oh my God, ये this is very nice. So you would means अगर हम कहीं जाते हैं ना, हमें बहुत excited होता है. चलो हम इसे लिख ले, हम फिर another time जब हम देखेंगे तो बहुत अच्छा feel होगा हमें. So do you write in your diary or just click photos for remembering?
I do both. मेरे पास ना एक छोटा सा notepad होता है that I always carry. अगर कुछ बहुत interesting दिखता है, कोई कुछ बोलता है जो मुझे पता है मुझे याद नहीं रहेगा, वो मैं लिख लेती हूँ. फिर मैं डे के एंड में when I go back to wherever I'm staying, a hostel or a hotel or a local space, I go there and I write anything else that I've missed. You know, जो मुझे पता होता है मुझे याद नहीं रहेगा वो मैं तभी लिख लेती हूँ या फिर फोन में टाइप कर लेती हूँ. और फिर डे के एंड में आई जस्ट क्रिएट अ स्मॉल नोट अबाउट दैट डे. तो मुझे पता है कि जब बाद में अगर मुझे इस जगह के बारे में लिखना है और कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन है जो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट थी जो मैं भूल जाऊंगी, तो मैं वो नोट कर लेती हूँ. इट लाइक जस्ट ऑलवेज कीप अ स्मॉल नोट पैड विद यू, कीप स्क्रिबलिंग एंड देन लुक एट इट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. देन यू कैन क्रिएट लाइक लॉन्गर नोट्स, बिकॉज अच्छा होता है अगर आप उसी दिन लिख लो ताकि याद रहे दिन भर क्या किया, किस तरह के लोगों से मिले, क्या खाना खाया. So it's good. I do that always. Somebody asked me about food as well. Like Sardaf asked me about the most interesting item of food I've ever tasted. Oh God, so much. So many things. So many things. The best bagels in New York. Great kebabs in Iran. And India mein to khair mujhe ghar ka khana bada acha lagta hai. If somebody gives me anything, I'll say mujhe ghar ka Kashmiri khana de do and I'm sorted. For life. But food, yes. अगर आप वेजिटेरियन भी हो या नॉनवेज जो भी हो, आप जगह पे जाके यू शुड ऑलवेज एक्सपीरियंस फूड, बिकॉज फूड इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ एनी कल्चर. इट जस्ट टेल्स यू सो मच अबाउट द पीपल, अबाउट द कल्चर, अबाउट द वेदर, अबाउट सो मेनी थिंग्स. तो फूड आई थिंक इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड समबडी आस्क्ड मी इफ आई विजिटेड जापान. नो, नॉट एज येट. अनदर थिंग, अनदर प्लेस ऑन माई लिस्ट, आई विल. This fascination with Asia, man, like Korea and Japan, that's nice.
So just wanted to have a time check here. It's about to be 4, so how much time would you be having with us?
So Didi, I want to say you one more thing. It's a very quick question.
Yes. Please tell us how much time would you be having so that accordingly I'll...
Yeah, I think you just have like 7 odd minutes left.
So you'll be needing to wrap by 4, right? So we'll just go ahead accordingly. All right, girls, we just have about 5 more minutes for Didi. So we'll be asking questions accordingly. Before Shifa goes ahead with her small short question, is there anybody else who did not get to ask and needs to ask something? Please raise your hands or probably write your question in the chat box quickly. Take 20 seconds to do that so that we know that you have asked. Okay. Zoha, you were telling you wanted to ask something. Would you like to ask right now, Zoha, Faiza, Mahira, Shama? All right. Till anybody else comes in, Shifa is already prepared. Shifa, go ahead. Ask them.
Yeah.
So my question is that when you travel and you go, so you do video call to your parents, or do you remember to your parents?
I remember my parents because I like to tell them what has happened. So I video call if possible. If not, I usually do a voice call, and I tell them that, hey, this is what I did, and I'm fine, and don't worry, and that's it. Yeah. There are times when I'm in places which does not have any network. So I tell them beforehand, listen, mom, dad, I'm going to be in a non-network area for the next 2-3 days. Don't worry. I'll be fine. As soon as I get back into a internet, like or a network area, I'll give you a call. So I think by now they have understood. They know if I tell them like, okay, she's going to get back to us as soon as she gets a signal. So that has also happened. But they're very supportive and I'm very grateful for that. But I, to give some credit to myself, I have kind of, you know, I think when I went to, by the time I was going to Iran, when I told my dad, like, dad, I am planning, I've planned my next destination. He said, where are you going? I said, Iran. And he said, tumhi jagahein kahan se dhoond ke laati ho? And I was expecting he would say, why? It's not safe. But he didn't say that because he'd already, I had groomed him over a period of it. I had showed him things about these places. I told him that, you know, essentially, people are the same everywhere. You know, you have to just be confident and make your way through. And don't worry, I've done it. I know it. And it's just a matter of reassuring your parents that you'll be fine. But it's always nice. I mean, you know, there are times when I want to take my parents along. And I did, like, I have traveled with them as well. I think that's a very nice and a very different feeling. If you take your parents and you kind of, like, take them to a trip and you show them around, they feel so nice and proud. And that's also a very good thing, you know. So Shiva, when you become like a travel blogger, and there'll be some time that you want to take your parents for a trip and you know it all, and you'll tell them, dekho ye yahan pe hai, they'll be very, very proud of you. So, yeah.
I'm also going with my parents to travel on 22nd, and I'm very excited. Wow. That
that's amazing. That's amazing.
Yes. I'm very excited that I will do read the stories and write the new things which I had observed in the train, and I'm very excited for that.
That's amazing. All the best. Have safe travels, and please give your regards to your parents from my side.
Thank you. And I want to give all the best and a thank to you.
Thank you so much, Shifa. Thank you. Means a lot.
Okay.
You're welcome.
There's something I wanted to ask before we close off, because we roughly have around 4 minutes left. We talked a lot about our passion around travel, how can we document it, what all safety and planning do we need. One health/food tip that you would want to give for at least people like me, and I'm sure a lot of my kids also, we love traveling, but we fall sick. Hame digestion issues hote. So what are certain food precautions or tips that experienced traveler would like to share to us?
Okay. Yeah, I know it's so bad to fall ill on a trip, huh? That's like the worst thing that can happen. But one, I think we know our system, right? We know when we are like on a day-to-day basis, when we're like eating, we know what ails our system and what aids our system, right? We know that already. So keep that in mind wherever you're going. If you have any allergies, of course, you're going to stay away from all of those things. If you know that you can't eat something that's like more very heavy on your tummy, make sure that you eat simple foods, like stick to a basic rice, dal, and, you know, always, and for, of course, for unforeseen circumstances, carry your medications with you, which are like for your tummy, for whatever else, but always be dehydrated. Even when you're going out, going on a trek, going somewhere, always carry a bottle of water. Very, very important. A lot of times what I do is I mix ajwain or mint with my water, and I keep taking a sip through the day. It just keeps my tummy flushed and clean as well. And it helps me digest if I'm having anything on the street, because we love street food, right? All of us love street food. And we want to explore that when you're going somewhere. So I do that. Warm water helps, really, really helps. If you're going to higher altitudes, if you know that you are not your body does not react too well to high altitude mountains, you can take that. Well, there's one medicine that you take to avoid, you know, nausea or anything. You can do that. I think if of course your vegetarian or non-vegetarian choices, you have to be kind of making sure that you get vegetarian if at all you are non-vegetarian places. A lot of times I do carry, but a lot of times I stay in a lot of hostels that allow me to cook as well. So a lot of times I actually go to the grocery store and buy my own food and cook it in the pantry. I've done that. When I don't want to eat out, I've like got eggs and simple bread or something and just like made a toast and had a coffee or tea and ate that. I just want to keep myself light. I've done that. So you can even do that in a lot of places that allow you to make your own food. Just like grab very simple. If you know that your system does not react too well to heavy foods or new foods, just be simple, break it. Have a simple food, have a complex food, have a simple food again, like maybe stick to one meal per day when you're having something very complex and new, and then give your system that break to kind of recuperate. So yeah, that's what I do.
It's a combination of being aware about your system and also trying to compromise a little of your taste and munchiness.
Yes.
For your
yes.
system again.
Yes. I was asking me what happens if I suddenly fall sick. If it's like really bad and medicines don't help and I have to go to a doctor, yeah, what to do? But I try, I think even your lifestyle, if you maintain a healthy lifestyle at home, it will show when you're traveling. If you are exercising, if you eat well, if your stamina is all right, it will always be good for you when you're traveling. So even when you're not traveling, you have to maintain a very nice, active, healthy lifestyle for your system to be healthy, to be able to take up any new things that come their way. You know, I think that's something that's very important.
It was really lovely. I think we went on different variants and almost had our own travel diary covered with important requisites and the to know points. And I really love the way the questions kept on coming. Would just love to know from Nupur, you and also the girls, like, how did this session go today? What are your closing thoughts about this session? And what was that one thing that you're going to take away from here today? I think Nupur Didi will go ahead, and then anyone from the girls can start sharing.
I loved it. I think it has been one of my best interactions thus far with students. I think everybody has been very forthcoming. The questions I loved, very smart girls, I must say, very well aware already. They know what they want. They know what they like. So I think it's amazing to be speaking with such confident, self-aware women. And I think you should remain this way. Be confident, be self-aware. Be kind, be loving, respect other people, and you're going to achieve whatever you want in your life, be travel or otherwise. Just be the way that you are, be self-aware and confident, and you'll achieve your dreams. And I will inform everybody when I go to Korea. Huh? I will, for sure. Now I have to go to Korea, so much pressure. I have to visit Korea now.
Yeah, the kids will come running. They'll be so happy. Tanya wants to share some closing thoughts. Yes, Tanya, go ahead.
So yes, Didi, I know that you all are like motivating all of us, but I know my future isn't going to be that bright. Because not only words that like I inspire you and you can do it, I believe in you, will not going to change anything, because I know the background of my family, how it is. And I know my future is not dark, but it's not that bright too.
No, Tanya.
I've never traveled that much, you know. Only Kutch, because my relatives live there and nothing else.
I completely understand your position. See, I think it begins with believing in yourself and believing that you can change it. So I know that you can't help the circumstances of your family, you know. You can't help it. And it is so brave of you to accept it. It is so brave and so smart of you to be aware. This is what we call self-awareness, right? You're accepting it, but at the same time, I think you know that you can carve a path for yourself beyond what has already been there in your family, right? If you make sure that you keep on with your studies, you go to college, you can get a job, you can start earning decent money, and then you can, you know, you can make that life for yourself that you want. I think circumstances are play a very major role. I'm not denying it. But
no, Didi, something happened in our family 2 or 3 years ago, which is ruined. Everything is ruined because of it, and I cannot share it as it's a personal family problem.
Sanya, same thing happened with me. You know, I had so many plans in 2016 and something happened in my family that just like derailed everything. Like I would have been somewhere out, somewhere else studying, and but I did not let it. I said, okay, it has happened. Now I can do nothing about it. What I can do is I can make sure that how I look at my life from now on, I can make it better. And okay.
You know, in short, my family has trust issues. I can say that.
Okay. Don't worry. See, you know that your family has trust issues. Now you write down, you take out a piece of paper. Every day you write down whatever issues you have, you know, write down whatever small thing steps you can do to kind of overcome it. See, it is not going to happen in one day or 1 month or even 1 year. But if in your mind you know that you're going to take out time to cross each little hurdle day by day, step by step, eventually in 1, 2, 3, 4 years, things will change. Things always change, Tanya. It is.
Didi, I never went out even with my family. How can I go out alone and myself?
Don't worry. See, once you become a little more independent, once you, right now, all you can do is make sure that you're studying really well. Once you're out of school, go to college. Once you become independent and you are in that capacity to make those decisions for yourself, things will change. You will be able to change things for yourself. You just have to believe in yourself.
Didi, again, that word is not going to change anything. I know my future. How is it going to be? I know you are motivating me so much, and I will use that all the advice you gave me, but I don't think it will help. But I will surely for try it. And I will show you the result. It will not be the same as you are saying it will be.
That's fantastic. You do try. Keep trying. I'm saying again, don't say that you know your future. Nobody knows the future, baby. Nobody knows it. You make your future.
Yeah.
So don't worry. It will be fine.
Baby, my future is not in my hands. I know that. My future is in my family's hands.
I get it. So at your age, Sanya, since you can be vulnerable and creating this safe space, I totally was like you. I was so dark about how everything's gonna be. Like, I never imagined I'll be teaching little babies like you, coming here, enjoying myself so much. I always thought, oh my God, will I even live after so many years? I was in that sort of a mind state. But things change, like Nupadidi said, things change. You just have to
people change. And you know, there are people you can reach out to help even in changing how your family thinks. There are people who work step by step in changing the behavior and attitude that have taken so many decades to build. There are ways to involve your family with external help that will help them change the way they think. You know, a lot of organizations do that. And it will happen, Sira. Don't worry. You don't lose.
And I also want to say this one thing, like we get dress coded in school, like, right? But in our house also, my father does like that. No, you cannot wear that and that. You only have to wear salwar kurta and nothing else.
Don't worry. You know, see, as long as you're living with your parents, there's not a lot you can do. If you rebel, they'll also get very angry. Right now, you in your head, you know that, okay, I'm living with them. You respect their wishes. But at the same time, you don't give up on your dreams. Nobody never ever give up on your dreams. You keep working towards them in the background, you know. They keep working towards them. You will get there. Things, when they see you happy, when they see you succeed, when they see you independent, they will have to change their mindset. So you work on yourself. You make that life for yourself. It will be absolutely fine slowly. Don't worry about it.
I hope it doesn't, I'm sure it won't give you a lot of motivation in the way you desire, right?
Yeah.
Now. But at least I'm sure that all of us have been at your place, like Jay Bhai had also shared. Life is either very long or very short. Nobody knows about it, right? So thank you, Nupur Didi, for holding such a safe space for all of us. Also lending your time, energy, and experiences to us. Sada, would you like to give some closing thoughts? I saw you turn your video on. Go ahead, come on. will be closing.
Yeah, so I would like to share that today's session was just amazing. And I really loved that how your thoughts about traveling and having inspiration in traveling and believing in you that things can change and we always have to be positive.
Thank you so much, Sadaf. Means a lot. Even if I've helped you girls like 1% in changing your perspective and, you know, reimagining your dreams, my job here is done. Thank you so much. You guys can reach out to me whenever. I'll be more than happy to help. And even travel, non-travel, anything. I'm always here for your help.
Thank you so much, Didi. It was really lovely to host another beautiful session. I remember last time I had a talk with a writer. Today, it's a travel blogger. And yeah, I'm just so happy to be here as well. Would request Jay to also share anything he wants to. Jay is my co-fellow. Yes, Jay.
Yeah.
Yeah, as I said in the TED Talks, and I was continually, like, in between also, I was continuing to type that this was one of the most interactive sessions. Even though we had, like, less number of students, they asked so many questions, like, there were brave questions as well. They asked questions around different things. They got profile as well. So initially we share profile with them and they read, Zoha also said that she had already visited the channel that was said in the profile. So yeah, I mean the amount of things that you have said, we will continue to discuss them in the class as well. I really like that some of them were able to connect it with their classroom as well, saying, oh, that's right, these are magic words. And
yeah,
like sessions like this ensures that the learning remains holistic and not just to the books. Like they can actually connect things and they'll continue to do that as well. So yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having me here. Thank you so much, guys.
It was lovely once again. Have a good day, good evening. Girls, you may just come off mic and just say bye to Didi with your pretty face. If possible, she will expect to see you all once.